Salutations, everyone. My name is Kinesis. It's lagging. My name is Kinesis. Welcome back to some more Fallout Tales 2 Wastelands. In the last episode, we finished up exploring the... If I can get my Pip-Boy out. We finished up exploring the Springvale School. And now we're inside the Super Duper Mart. And then we got the medicine that actually... Oh, I didn't actually grab the medicine. I just... Game! Oh my god. Is it okay now? It's like this game can't... Alright, whatever. I got the medicine now. Alright, so I got the medicine from Moira. And now we are going to head out. Or at least try to. There's also more food right here. Why you were not doing anything? But okay. Come on.
You're dead.
I'll take that. That's it. Pow! So yeah, I've actually been playing some Mario Kart lately, and I'm actually trying to 3-star all the cups, and that's really hard. I'm not even going to lie, it's actually very hard to 3-star all of the CCs and all that stuff. It's actually somewhere I want to go. I think there's still someone here, I don't know. I think now this place is empty, but I don't know. Oh, never mind. Oh, come on. I don't know why my bullets were completely silent, but okay. And I was also just standing there too. I probably should have. Oh my god, why is my game so laggy all of a sudden? It was fine a couple episodes ago. And, no, I am not recording all these episodes in one go. Still not gonna take the dirty water. The game, why are you laggy? I'm guessing it's just because it's still Fallout New Vegas in the world of Fallout 3, so I guess it should be laggy. At least a little bit from my computer. But, it's still bad. Alright. The audio is also a little delayed, but whatever. Also, I changed the color to green to represent Fallout 3 a little bit more. So, yeah. Anyway, let's head out. Actually, I think there's another vending machine on the other side of this, and I want to grab the new pills in there. Only because I want to make those into... Oh, it's not... Okay. There is not a vending machine over here. I'm actually going to go ahead and save. In case if the game crashes, which I don't know. I don't think it would. Only because it's been doing fine this far away, but just make sure. Whoa. He was like acting a little bit weird now. I hope that's like not. Whatever. Alright, let's just head back home. So that we can store some stuff and exchange the quest to Moira. Alright, just making sure that I'm actually the iPhone 6 being recorded. Also, I do have my window open. So if there's white. Why am I zoomed in? Why am I zoomed in? Oh, whoops. I can't even take out my weapon. What is going on? I have no idea what's going on. Alright, hold on. What if I do this? No. Alright, guys, I'll be right back. I gotta restart the game. Because I have no idea what's going on. Alright, I'm back. It's fixed. I hope. Let's try and go to Megaton now. Alright. Better. Voice crack. Alright. I don't even remember what I was talking about now. Let's just put my stuff away. And maybe also the lag has stopped. I hope, actually. Some ducking, dog hide. Duct tape. I guess I'll stuff this in there only because I don't want to carry that around. Actually, you know what? Let's pre-war money. Give me this. Oh! Remember what I put in here? So I'm just gonna. What I'm gonna do is that I'm actually gonna put unique weapons into this. In this one right there. Now I actually will try and do some. Freaking. What's it called? DLCs? Why can't I remember? Why can I not remember the word DLC? I am not that. I'm not thinking straight, apparently. I think I'll have to grab these, that, just to sell. Alright, good. I'm gonna go ahead and head over to Moira so I can sell all my stuff. What time is it? Okay, I think I don't know what time Moira closes. I only know what time she opens. And Moira, when did I have poison? remember me having poison, ever. It's also a random locked refrigerator. Apparently, I shouldn't go into Crayoside Supply, but I'm gonna do it anyways.
No, I think I've found a new way to prepare rad roach meat. Still tastes like old feet, though. Anyway, what's up with you?
I also, started up my mod to change, like, the speech bubbles and the inventory screens or whatever. Let's talk about collecting the stuff from Super Duper Mart.
So, how's the scavenging been? Got the food and medicine from that Super Duper Mart?
It wasn't easy, but I got the food and medicine.
Really? You did? You did! Well, all right! Tell me all about it.
The Rays were using the pharmacy as a place to store their best gear.
So you're saying that they acquired a well-protected stash? I wonder how many other places are hiding treasures behind monsters. Well, keep what you got. Just traded for a big food shipment myself. Here, take a bit, my treat. Tastes kinda grates after a while. Oh, and take this. It's an old food sanitizer. Just carry it with you, and it should automatically make most food and drink more, better.
What? Now I got the food sanitizer, that's nice. I'm probably going to be using that a lot only because I mostly use food other than medicine, but whatever. I'm ready to continue research on the first chapter.
I still need to study a living specimen with radiation poisoning. I need someone to research how to travel through a minefield. And that'll cover the first section of the book. Which strikes your fancy?
What's this about radiation?
Well, that's what I need your help for, isn't it? I know lots about it from books, but I never seem to get a live example. Not for long, anyway. So I need you to get a bit of radiation poisoning, so I can study its effects. Oh, not a deadly dose, of course. I can fix you up before that.
Okay, you want me to get irradiated? How could that possibly be worth it for me?
Oh, don't worry so much.
I don't know why my game's being retarded.
I'll be waiting with a nice tall glass of rad cleansing Brahmin milk for you when you get back.
Why is my game like this?
Mostly just a whole lot of rad X and rad away, and maybe even a more reliable way to get rid of radiation, assuming it works, of course.
Okay, Radiant. Just be ready to fix me up when I get back.
Oh, you're a peach. Or at least some sort of hardy fruit that grows in the savagely irradiated mockery of agriculture we have nowadays.
Conga fruit.
Now, 200 rads should be enough for basic sickness. But if you can get 600 or more rads, my test will be even more accurate. Just make sure you can get back here, and I'll see to it that you're well taken care of.
All right. Now let's start sewing stuff.
Sure.
Game. Oh my god. That. Oh my god. game is being so dumb right now. Alright, let's start grabbing some of your stuff. Let's actually put a workbench inside of our house. Night.
Good hunting.
I don't know why Create Stash Supply was red, by the way. Normally that happens when you're looking at a door or something that you can interact with that you're not supposed to go into.
We shall see our release.
Like, see how this is red? That's something you're not supposed to do.
Yay, your suffering shall exist no longer. It shall be washed away in Adam's glow.
Be careful with that.
Burned.
You be careful with that. Anyways, Graditch. I guess we can do a little bit of the main quest, but I'm not going to be doing much because this, in Fallout 3, you see super mutants very early in the game. But in Fallout New Vegas, you see super mutants kind of late in the game. So the only problem with playing Tales of Two Wastelands is that this game has super mutant difficulty in the world of Fallout 3.
Colin Moriarty, always pleased to see a new face, but I'm afraid you've had the misfortune to catch me, well, out of me element. I'm the owner and proprietor of Moriarty's, you see. The saloon. But please, see for yourself. Come by for a drink or 12. You and I, oh, we're going to be fast friends. Fast friends.
I'm looking for my father, middle age. Have you seen him?
My God, it's you. The little baby girl all grown up. Persistent little flower, ain't you? Then and now, it would seem. It's been a long time, kid. Oh, your daddy passed through here, all right. Here and gone. Got what he came for and then left. I'm assuming you'll do the same, correct?
Huh? My father and I were born in Vault 101.
Is that what your father told you? That you were born in that hole? That he was born there as well? Oh, the lies we tell to those we love. Your father brought you to the vault right after you were born. To keep you safe, you see. I remember it well. You stayed in my saloon, after all. That's right. Your father, his Brotherhood of Steel friend, and you, the suckling babe with nary a tit to suckle. Sorry about your mom, truly. But life goes on. Daddy lied. Life's full of little disappointments. And now you're all grown up and wondering where he's gone to.
Oh, I wasn't born in the vault? Okay, no, not saying that. You're wrong. My dad would never lie to me.
Ah, I see. You know, I heard about the brainwashing that goes on down there. From some other fella, escaped. Oh, 5 years back. All hail the Overseer. We're born in the vault, we die in the vault, and all that other assorted lunacy. Kid, you've got better programming than our own Deputy Weld. You'd best wise up quick. Wouldn't want anyone taking advantage of you, hmm?
I guess I could do this.
You seem like a nice kid, so I'm going to be straight with you. Your dad was here, and now he's not. And yes, I know where he went. But what you're asking me for is information, and information is a commodity. And like any commodity, it must be sold at a reasonable market price. So what's reasonable? Let's say, 100 caps, and Daddy's location's yours.
Alright, Moriarty, here's 100 caps. Now where's my father?
Excellent. Your dad raised a smart kid. Really no substitute for the love of a father, now is there? Speaking of dear old Dad, he went southeast, into DC, to the Galaxy News radio station. Good luck now.
Now we know where Dad is, apparently. And he's apparently over here somewhere. Now, actually, fun fact, I actually never met my dad. Like, Phantom definitely did, but me, I didn't, because I was actually caught as a Ralts. And, I was raised up to a Curly, as you can obviously tell right now. But then, I was released by my trainer. It's actually why I'm nicknamed. That's why I'm named Kinesis. What am I doing? I'm supposed to get irradiated. That's why my name is Kinesis. If I wasn't caught, my name would be just Curlia. But Phantom never had a trainer. So I guess he gave himself that nickname? I don't know.
He's a junkie. A total chemist.
Behold! He is coming with the clouds. And every eye shall be blind with his glory.
Right.
Every ear shall be stricken deaf
funny, though,
to hear the thunder of his voice.
I have no idea why my game is being laggy like this.
Children of the earth, come forth to gather and behold the power of Atom.
Slurp, slurp, slurp,
those
slurp,
who dwell here
slurp,
in his
slurp,
land,
slurp, 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 slurp. I don't know what I'm doing.
Come forth and drink the waters of the glow. For this ancient weapon of war is our salvation. It is the very symbol of Atom's glory.
Slurp! 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 I don't know why, but that's like very funny to me. Do not ask me why.
You should probably leave, you know.
Well, you should probably, Jesus! Ah! Sorry about that, I just swallowed some spit. I'm as irradiated as I can get without burning a hole in the floor.
I can tell. You're positively glowing. Now, just hold on and try not to move. Tell me how it feels, and I'll get you fixed right up.
If I listen closely, I can hear my jeans crying.
So, you're experiencing delusions, too. Fascinating.
Now, literally.
After taking a few notes, I'll take care of that nasty radiation with a bit of my own homemade concoction. I've never had a chance to test it out on someone so heavily dosed, but I'm sure it'll work out fine. Exciting, isn't it?
I'm gonna die, aren't I?
Okay, a little Brahmin milk, a couple magnets, and maybe a few happy thoughts. Well, you're alive! Oh, that's the good news. But there was a little side effect. A teeny tiny, mutation. But it seems to be benign, at least. Here, take a few radiation chems, as my little way of saying, I'm sorry I twisted your DNA like a kitten with a ball of yarn.
Rad regeneration perk added. Moira's experiment had an unexpected side effect. Now, when you suffer from advanced radiation poisoning, crippled limbs automatically regenerate. This is one of my favorite perks ever. It saves me so much time from going to my inventory, going to stats, and clicking on my limbs, wasting stim packs, just to restore my limbs. I love this perk so much. Let's finish up that chapter with that landmine research.
Landmines are one of the few dangers out there that you can profit from. Disarm one before it blows, and you can sell it for plenty of caps. I've heard stories about a ghost town that's just full of mines. Traders just call the place Minefield. Sounds like the place for some field work. Get in there, get back, and tell me all about it. And could you bring back a mine for my studies?
That seems kind of... Unhealthy. How about you make it worth my while?
What better reward for avoiding explosives than to pay you with explosives? Frag grenades, in this case. I got a pretty good haul of them recently.
Frag grenades!
And if you bring me back something to study, maybe I can make some modifications for you. Nothing like tinkering with a live mine, right?
Yeah. You're gonna kill yourself. I'll head into minefield. Wish me luck.
Oh, don't worry. No one ever goes there because they say it's a ghost town. And since ghosts don't exist, you can just focus on the landmines. Here there's a playground in the middle of town. Reach that point and come back, and I'm sure you'll have some stories to tell.
I wouldn't say ghosts don't exist. I bet if Phantom was playing this game, he would be kind of mad. Yeah, if Phantom was playing this game, definitely he would be a little bit mad because she would basically say that he doesn't exist. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and get advanced radiation poisoning right now.
No longer. It shall be washed away in Atom's glow. Burned from you
slurp,
the fire
slurp,
of
slurp, slurp, slurp,
of
slurp,
shall give birth
slurp,
to a
slurp,
stars
slurp,
formed
slurp,
of our
slurp. Okay,
bodies.
That's enough.
Each of us
there we go. Advanced radiation poisoning. So now I should have, yep, rad limb healing. So now whenever my limbs get damaged or they break, this perk will now fully heal it, I think. Alright, how is my storage doing anyways? 134. I think I'm actually good. Pow. Game, don't you dare crash on me! Oh! Apparently the game still looks like it's loading on OBS. But for me, what I got was a white screen from the next stuff. Okay, actually, quick thing! I actually want to show this off real quick. This is just something funny. I don't know why it's added into the game, but
the more time I spend talking to you, the less I'm spending watching for raiders. How the hell did you get up here anyway?
Yeah, because there's no other way getting up here unless you cheat. So that's just a little cool, I guess, Easter egg. So we are heading over here.
Need some grub.
So let's just go ahead and head up and go out on an adventure. I have to say, the world of Fallout 3 used to be one of my favorites. Like, I used to really love the world of Fallout 3, only because I actually used to hate Fallout New Vegas, because I felt like the world had nothing in it. I felt like the world of Fallout New Vegas was completely empty. Oh, that's actually another kid I missed. I felt like Fallout New Vegas was completely empty of stuff to do. I just felt like there was nothing to do in that world other than just talk to people and do the main quest. While I was playing Fallout 3, And it felt like everywhere you go, there's something to do. But now I actually don't feel that way anymore. To be honest, I actually favor Fall New Vegas than Fallout 3. Because actually on Steam, Fallout New Vegas is my most played game by far. I have like 200 plus hours spent on New Vegas. Probably because I've been filling this game with mods, despite my computer being terrible. Or our computer, I should say. I keep saying my, but really, I share this with Phantom. Because we use this to record. Okay, I guess we're going down. Because I couldn't get back up. Whatever. So yeah, I share this computer with Phantom. Because we use this to record. So, and it would be kind of difficult to record two different, like, types of videos with Phantom plays and Kinesis plays on two different types of computers. Is there anything over here? And the video is lagging for some odd reason. So yeah, I used to like Fallout 3 better than Fallout New Vegas. But now I actually favor Fallout New Vegas than Fallout 3. Around here? Nope. I don't know why there's a random boat and dock over here. Like, there's no water. Unless this used to be, like, water too, but still. Seems a little bit too high to be water. Now you guys know what I mean by our computer is terrible. Because you literally just saw how bad the draw distance is for our game. Well, technically, okay, the video's lagging. Technically, this game is mine because I did pay for it. Kind of. I'm just gonna do this. Kapow! You guys actually have varmint rifles. Oh, I'll definitely take that. That's actually our first long range weapon. Nice. Can I reach you? Yes, I can. And you have a varmint rifle. Alright, you know what? I'm actually gonna end this off here. This game is being laggy for some odd reason. I grabbed money out of nowhere. So, I'm gonna end this off here. So next time on... Next time on Fallout, Tales of Two Wastelands, we'll be going ahead and heading off to go over to freaking Minefield, and also be I'm getting distracted a little bit. We'll be going off into Minefield, grabbing a mine, and I think it said travel to the playground in the minefield. Yeah, we'll be going ahead to Minefield, heading over to the playground, and actually grabbing a mine for Moira. See you guys then. Goodbye!